To grasp the fundamental concept of binary search, it is essential that we are able to execute it manually before we delve into coding. Let's consider an example of an array of 9 elements sorted in ascending order, and suppose we want to find the position of the element 40. Before we begin, I'll list 4 simple rules that we will apply to specific scenarios as we encounter them. I'll explain these rules as we proceed. Now, let's go over the 4 basic steps that we will perform in binary search. The first step is to find the middle element of the given array. The second step is to compare the middle element with the element we're trying to find. The third step involves splitting the array into 2 parts and discarding one of them. The fourth step is where we repeat the process with the subarray under consideration until we either find the element or determine that it is not present in the array. Although this may seem daunting at first, don't worry. By the end, you will have a clear understanding of the process. Let's start by finding the middle element of the given array. Solving the problem manually helps to develop the skills needed for more efficient and effective coding. It also enables early error detection, which is a critical skill for programmers. So don't worry about the code implementation of finding the middle element. I'll cover that part in detail, including various scenarios. Right now, our focus is on solving this problem manually to understand the concept. Let's compare the middle number, which is 60, with the element we're trying to find, which is 40. In this case, since 60 is greater than 40, rule number 4 applies. According to this rule, we consider the left subarray as our new array and discard the right subarray and the middle number. This makes sense because all the elements to the right of 60 are greater than 40, including 60. One thing to keep in mind is that whenever we split an array into 2 subarrays and discard one of them, we will always discard the middle element along with it. Continuing to work with the middle element does not make sense as it is not a match. So we discard the right subarray and the middle element and focus on the left subarray where there is a chance of finding the element we are looking for. We repeat the process to find the middle element once again. However, since the new array has even number of elements, we have 2 elements in the middle. Rule number 1 applies in this case, which states that if there are 2 elements in the middle, we consider the left one as the middle element and proceed. Therefore, 20 becomes the middle element and is compared with 40. Since 20 is less than 40, according to rule number 3, we choose the right subarray. We discard the middle element 20 and any element to the left of it, which is 10 in this case. Now, we have an array consisting of only 2 elements. We find a new middle number. Considering both elements in the array as middle elements, rule number 1 applies here, and we consider the left one as the middle element. We compare it with 40 and see that the middle element is smaller. Thus, rule number 3 applies here. We choose the right subarray. We discard the middle element, which is 30, and the left subarray. Now we are left with an array consisting of only 1 element, which is naturally the middle element. We compare it with 40 and it's a match. According to rule number 2, if it's a match, we return its position. But what if the element we are looking for isn't present in the array? Before addressing that scenario, I want to let you know that my aim is to ensure that you have a solid understanding of coding concepts and algorithms. This way, you can concentrate on real programming tasks at hand. If you find my content helpful and informative, please consider subscribing to my channel. Your subscription serves as an indication that I'm creating useful and engaging content for the tech enthusiasts out there. Okay, let's explore a scenario where the element we're searching for is not present in the given array sorted in ascending order. To illustrate, let's imagine that we were searching for 41 instead of 40. Which was the middle number we were comparing in the previous example. In this case, the 2 elements don't match and rule number 3 comes into play, requiring us to solve the right subarray, excluding the middle element. However, this approach leaves us with no elements or subarrays to search. So, we return -1. I will give a comprehensive tutorial on how to incorporate these ideas into coding in my next video. If you have any questions or suggestions, feel free to leave a comment below. Thanks for watching. I'll hopefully see you in my next video.